Individually, you are to be a living sanctuary. Collectively, we are a living sanctuary. Ah, it becomes so exciting because when you see God's plan, we have to ask ourselves, because I am a living sanctuary for the Lord, how do I live my daily life?
Because non-Christians have very high standards for Christians. People see us. We are a living epistle. People judge our God by our actions. Let me say it this way. We can get to that place in God to where we want the benefits of His kingdom without our involvement. We want the blessing, but we don't want to do anything. We don't want to participate. When you become satisfied with where you are in your Christian walk, you can say, well, we have progressed. Many of us are hearing God. Many of us are able to give a prophetic word. Many of us, we can love our times of worship. But you know, we can get stuck in that one place and not grow beyond, because that's a good place. It's a feel-good place. The priest was to ensure that the church does not become satisfied just having meeting, but we have to keep the fire of revival, the baptism of fire from the Holy Spirit in our churches until we cry out, oh God, come now, Lord, stir the fire of revival, stir the fire of sacrifice, stir the fire for the lost, stir the fire for our purpose to be a kingdom church, God. Keep the fire burning now and for the next generation. I don't want just the feel-good feeling. I want the power feeling. I don't want to be satisfied with being stroked. Okay, feel good, feel good, feel good. It's good to feel good. But I want to walk in power. That when the devil brings problems to me, I say, okay, come on, man. Come on. Bring it on. I'm ready for you.